It turned out that by okay, I have to tell you one more secret about what you have to do in order to see this new phenomena that I discovered. For this, you need to do something that I call weak measurements. In the ordinary measurement in quantum mechanics that you have the disturbance that I talked about, what you do is you make an experiment that interacts very strongly with the particle to find exactly where it is. But suppose instead you develop the notion of a very, very gentle experiment, that you look at the particle so gently that you hardly disturb it at all. You pay the penalty that you get very, very little information. So what you do, you repeat the experiment many, many times, and each time that you get exactly the same conditions, you collect the results, and by collecting enough results, you can find out the message, namely what the particle is trying to tell you. So this is called weak measurement, and that is the way that you can see both waves. Only by weak measurement that sees very little in each case, but when you repeat it many, many times, then you can see what the future wave is telling you. So now I discovered that if you do such weak measurements, you have many, many interesting new phenomena. Many of them now are being actually experimented in many laboratories in the world. But the one that I'm going to tell you about now, I just nearly finished with my colleagues writing the articles about it, so expect this experiment to be done in the near future. And the experiment is like this. I take a quantum particle, for example, a photon, and the photon has the possibility of moving in some direction, and also the possibility of having a rotation. The little photon can rotate either clockwise or anti-clockwise. And this is called polarization, that can have two values. It's value plus one if it rotates one way, and value minus one if it rotates another way. So you take this photon, and you send it here through half-reflective mirror, that the part of the photon goes this way, and part of the photon goes this way. So it behaves at this point like the wave, that's separating into two parts. Then you put a mirror here, and a mirror here, so the photon now continues this way and that way. And then you put another half-reflected mirror here, and the photon can come this way or that way, and you collect only those photons that came in this way. So that is the initial preparation. That's what I called psi 1, is this one, and the final one is just that one that goes here. So I discard all the possibilities where the photon went this way. And now it turns out that if you do on each one of these photons a very weak experiment, and the weak experiment does the following. If the photon is going this way, you put on it a very, very tiny force, sort of force, that pushes it in this direction. And then you put on the same photon another tiny force that puts it in the orthogonal direction depending on the polarization. If the polarization is positive, it goes one way. If it's negative, it goes another way. Now, the fact that the experiment is very weak means that the change in the photon is very small compared to the uncertainty, so that shift cannot be seen on an individual photon. It can be seen only if you collect many, many photons. And then, if you do the right post-selection and look on only those photons, you find out that the photons that went here were not pushed at all in this direction, as if there was no photon there. But they were pushed in the orthogonal direction as if there was a polarization. And the part of the photon that went here was actually just showing that there was a photon there, but no polarization. So this experiment, I expect, will be done very soon in the future, and then we'll understand what Lewis Carroll meant that he separated the smile from the cat. Thank you.